Today we will start exercise 1.2. Exercise 1.2 related to irrational numbers. Okay. In my first lecture, I explained their rational number, irrational numbers, natural numbers, all the numbers. Irrational numbers means the numbers which cannot be expressed in P by Q form. The numbers which cannot express are known as irrational numbers. Okay. And rational numbers, irrational numbers. Together they are called the real numbers. Okay. So start. Exercise 1.2. First question. First question. True, false, justify your answer. Justify means you have to write true, then why it is true. If false, then why it is false. First question. Every irrational number is a real number. True or false? It is false. Because real number is the collection of all rational number and irrational numbers. True, because all rational numbers and irrational numbers together called real numbers. Okay. Now second question is every point on the number line is of the form square root of m, where m is the natural number. Okay, in a number line, every point, you know, in a draw a number line, in number line, midpoint is 0 and right side are the positive integers plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, that's say plus 4, and left side negative integers minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Okay. Now let's, if 1 is the square root of 1, 2 is the square root of 4, 3 is the square root of 9, okay, but in left side, minus 1 is not square root of any number, right? If you write minus 1 equal to minus 1, minus 2 is the square root of minus 4, that are the wrong, okay? So, every point on the number line is of the form root. If this explanation is wrong, because negative integers cannot be expressed in square root m form. So write false because no negative numbers can be expressed in square root of m form. Okay. Now third question. Third question is every real number is an irrational number. So write every real number is an irrational number. Every real number is an irrational number. Real numbers are the collection of all rational numbers and irrational numbers. So, real number means rational number and irrational numbers. So every real number means they are not irrational, because rational numbers are also included there. So it is the false statement. So write false, because irrational numbers are the part of real numbers. Okay, two false, three are there. Then second question, question number three, are the square roots of all positive integers irrational? That means, examples are the square root of all positive integers. Okay, take the square root of 4 equal to 2. 2 is a rational number. Okay, but if you take square root of 5, it is irrational number. So this statement is false. So write no. The square root of 4 is a rational numbers. So all the square root of all positive integers are not irrational. Okay, all some numbers are rational, some numbers are irrational. So this expression is a false. Okay, our exercise is 1.2, question number 1 and question number 2 over. Today up to this much. Thank you.